One of our favorite Italian chefs is going a little green for St. Patrick's Day. We're going to call her just for today, Stefanie Paganini.
Why not? Why not?
Might as well. Anyway.
I've had the privilege of being to Ireland, and I joked that they remind me of Italians. They just speak English.
All right.
They're wonderful.
Talk about where you're from.
So in Ireland?
No, not Ireland, the school.
The school. I was like, the Paganini School of
there
Cooking.
There you go, there
Thank you.
Thank
you. So we, obviously, as you know, we are a cooking school. We do classes for the public, but we also have our trade school.
And I know a lot of your graduates as well.
Yeah.
Yes, that's wonderful.
And so today we're going to make something that's thought to be a classic Irish dish, but here's the twist on it. Soda bread. So this is a bread that's actually leavened or raised, not with yeast, mm-hmm. but with baking soda.
Okay.
It actually originates from here in the United States.
Did not know that.
Native Americans were the first to take an ash from wood trees and use that ash, which had a soda element to it, to raise their bread. And then in the 1800s, it became popular in Ireland when the potato famine was around. They would take baking soda and they would make bread with baking soda, and they would eat that yeast bread or that baking soda bread with wheat versus a potato bread that they were making.
Good history lesson. That's good stuff.
Isn't that too much? More than people want to know first thing in the morning.
No, that's fine. That's good stuff.
Sorry, but okay, so let's make it.
I can use that, the stump, Scott.
Yeah. Or if you go on Jeopardy, just give me 10% of your winnings. That's all I ask.
All right, you got a lot of stuff going on.
So we're going to do, it's like sort of like a quick bread in the way that you mix it. So in here, we've got our dry goods. We've got 4 cups of flour. So this is a heavy, dense bread.
Yeah.
And we're going to sift in there. I'm going to have you do this job. Cinnamon, salt.
Nice.
Of course, we're using a lot of baking soda.
Okay.
And we're going to use a little baking powder, which is going to have the acid in it we need to activate our baking soda.
Okay.
So if you want to sift that into your bowl.
You want me to do what now?
Go ahead and sift. Yep.
This
you know what
you
I
do?
Like to do when I sift? I like to kind of shake my hips too. So it's kind of an aerobic exercise.
There you go. I like it.
You
got to stand back though. You get a little messy.
You do.
Huh?
I mean, you have such a nice
suit.
Only
because I have a dark suit. If I had a lighter suit,
it'd
nice.
Be
good.
All right, so then we're going to put all the wet stuff in here. I've got brown sugar.
Okay.
Got a little bit of white sugar.
Should I do this yet?
I think you got to do that. Melted butter, about 2 tablespoons of melted butter.
Good.
We're going to add 4 egg yolks, which is the nice fatty part of the egg.
Okay.
None of that healthy white part. and then we're going to add our mix-ins. So we're using what are called sultanas, but they're golden raisins. It's just a fancy name for them.
Nice.
And then commonly, Irish soda bread has caraway seeds in it, which is that, you know, that kind of, it's got like a little bit of a bitter or sour taste to it.
Okay.
But I don't like that.
So what do you put instead?
As a chef, I changed it. I'm using currants.
Oh, nice.
And currants are actually a type of black raisin. They're just a smaller version. So I've got currants and I've got golden raisins. And I'm going to mix this all together and then dump this into the bread.
Dump it in. All right.
Here we go.
I like it.
And then we're going to mix that all together.
Okay.
And while you're doing that, you're going to bake this in a, I call it like a little loaf pan.
Mm-hmm.
This is a nice deep one. I've buttered it, otherwise your bread won't come out. And then once it all mixes together, we would put the batter in here.
Okay.
And then we would take little bits of butter and we're going to just plop them on top.
Okay.
So it gets sort of that wonderful kind of dark butter crust.
Okay.
And you,
It's starting to stick to the...
You know why? I forgot to tell you to add the milk.
So the whole thing?
Yeah, throw it
all
in
right,
there.
That's what happened.
Poor Wayne is like getting an arm
workout. I know,
arm
I'm wondering. Well,
you're such a trooper. You're like, this isn't coming together.
Right, see, you're the expert. I'm going with you. But okay, we just put the milk. And it's okay if you put the milk in late, not
it's
a big deal.
Sure, it's no big deal. It's really a dump and mix recipe.
Right, yeah.
So once it all gets in, we'll put it in there. And then it's going to bake for a long time.
How long?
You have it in a 350 degree oven for about an hour.
Oh, that's not bad.
Yeah, so once it bakes, and we can pretend that that's all done.
Okay.
Poor thing. Thank you.
I'm ready to try the bread anyway, actually.
So over here, we have the bread, and we're going to slice it up. You can see it comes out pretty nicely from the container.
Okay.
And then what I did is I made a little bit of a butter, a honey butter with it.
Yes.
You can take a cup of regular butter. Sorry, I just moved the... You can take a cup of regular butter and you can mix in a little bit of honey. But for the cooking class that we're making this bread in, we're actually going to make our own butter.
Okay.
We're going to whip heavy whipping cream until it curdles, and then we're going to actually produce our own butter to then make our honey butter from.
Can we talk a little bit about the individuals who may want to be part of your cooking class?
Yeah.
What's the process?
So if you want to register for, like, let's say this is our Irish pub class, which is coming up on March 10th. It's a hands-on class. You would call the school or go online and register at lpscinc.com. Or if you're interested in coming to our professional program, just call me at the school. We'll give you a tour of the school. We have a spring class starting. What's great about our professional spring class is that it's a Saturday-only program. So even if you're working Monday through Friday, you can go through culinary school, just coming to our school all day Saturday.
Excellent.
Yeah.
Good stuff.
What hey, do you
this
think?
Is very nice.
Oh,
I like
good.
It.
I'm glad
like
you like it. It's a little sweet for breakfast.
Fine with me.
Good.
Thank you. I appreciate that.
Sure,
thank you.
No problem.